Hi everyone, Chad Burton here, CEO of Kiro Legal, and we're going to talk about client interaction and service in the virtual law firm context. Now, if you've watched the other videos in this series, that's an underlying theme. All of this, no matter what we do as lawyers, has to tie back to better serving the client. That sounds like a given, but we always have to have that in the back of our minds. Is what we're doing, is this virtual model we're developing, is that good for client service? Is that serving their needs? First, let's think about your online interaction. How do you normally communicate with your clients? Well, anymore, we're talking email and texting. Even some lawyers are concerned about texting with clients. I think that's going away finally, but email and texting, pretty popular ways of doing things. But there are also some pretty creative ways, like using platforms like Slack. Slack is a good way to think about Slack as an enterprise social media tool. So think about Facebook with updates and private messages in smaller groups. Slack is just for your company or your firm, and what you can do is you can create channels and invite outside folks, such as clients, to communicate that way. That's kind of a cool idea where you aren't getting bombarded with emails, and it has a real-time experience because there are apps for your iPhone and your Droid and your iPad so that you get real-time notifications and it reduces your email. If you're an Office 365 user, there's an app called Yammer. We actually used this in Burton Law back in the early days of the virtual law firm, and it is, again, like Slack, it's a enterprise social media tool, but it allowed us to communicate real time. And Microsoft bought it, I think, 3 or 4 years ago, and they haven't ruined it yet. So if you're a 365 subscriber, you get that within that package. So that's a cool thing for law firms to use. And again, like Slack, you can invite clients and outside groups to your Yammer account and set up private chats with them. It's a pretty creative way to communicate with them. Let's take this idea of online interaction a step further. We're all familiar with LegalZoom, and probably most of you just groaned when I said LegalZoom, maybe not out loud because you're sitting by yourself, but at least in your head as you're watching this video. A lot of lawyers have this adverse, kind of feel to LegalZoom because they feel like they're taking work from us. There's something really important to think about here and how consumers are engaging with LegalZoom. They're driving over, I think it's like $140 million in revenue in inexpensive wills, business startups, trademarks, etc. That's a lot of simple wills that people are going online, filling out questionnaires, paying with a credit card, and getting a document. Now, yes, LegalZoom is adding the idea of lawyers into the mix on it, but what we know, and the purpose of this, is that consumers of legal services in the U.S. are going online looking for help. Well, how can law firms leverage this? Well, there's a platform called Direct Law. There's a firm in Arizona called Modern Law that created their own document automation application that potential clients in the family law world can go in and, actually they used to be able to buy documents. Now the firm just gives away the documents for free. But it's a way to provide meaningful value to clients online where people are going. Direct Law allows clients to go to a law firm's webpage, log in to Direct Law and buy forms, whether it's for estate planning, for business needs, whether it's a startup or you need NDAs. And what happens there is the interaction up front is between the lawyer and the online form. They fill out the questionnaires, and it's like a choose your own adventure, and it's smart questioning based on the choices of how they've answered. And once those are complete, the client enters a credit card payment, and then the form is auto-generated on the back end for the lawyer in the law firm to review. Then you interact with the client that way and finalize the documents. With this platform and others like it, you're able to reach clients that aren't going to hire you anyways. They're not going to a traditional law firm. They're looking online for ways to obtain legal services. That's something that's kind of tough for a traditional law firm to get your head around, but it fits nicely within the virtual model because you're already operating in that remote sense. Well, you're remote, but your clients are also remote as well. When I said this is kind of, we're a bit ahead of the curve right now, it's seeing traction in the US, and I think the legal zooms of the world are going to make it go a lot faster. But like in the UK and Australia, they've really advanced this model so that clients are buying this a lot more and interacting with their law firms a lot more on that front. And a lot of it has to do with their adding additional services onto it. Not everybody is completely comfortable with interacting with your law firm online. So have a number for them to call. I've mentioned Ruby receptionists in other videos. Have Ruby be able to answer basic information about the platform. Not legal advice, just how to do it. They need help on how to do it because they're not used to it. That's pretty powerful stuff. It's a bit of hand-holding, but you're mixing people with the technology to help make the client feel comfortable and have a really good experience.